I'm near a Cabot site now. I'm approaching the Cabot site, and I'm under an injunction, a permanent one. This is my third injunction from Cabot through the courts here in my county. And this one happened in May, which is tells me where I can stop, where I can park, how far I have to stay from the Cabot driveway and from a Cabot gas site. So right now, this is the site across the road. So I'm on a public road. This is Post Pond Road. So what I do now is I drive slowly by and show people, because I do tours almost every week, citizen gas tours. So I'm going slow and show people that there's houses near everything, a lot of these sites, and that driveway is approaching. I'm supposed to stay 25 feet away from their driveway if I'm walking. So while I'm driving, I drive by, and if I park, I have to park 100 feet from the driveway. There's no markers here. I have to estimate. So this is a pretty wide driveway. Not all of them are this wide. Cabot has about 190 driveways in my county. So I have to watch myself at 190 spots in my county. So this one has the landowner's name. Fontana is the Fontana site. They have their little signs, no trespassing, no this, no that. So now I'm going to go. I can park on the road 100 feet or in someone's private driveway if I have permission. So I have permission across the road. This is somebody I know, a friend of mine, Shanji, and I'm going to park in his driveway, and then I can pull out and I can walk around on the road, but I got to make sure I stay on the other side of the road if I stop walking, and otherwise I can't stop within 25 feet, but I can stop across the road, off the road. It has to be off the road. And then if I have people with me, I have to warn them and tell them. Let's see if I can read this, if it says what I'm supposed to tell people.
So what have you got there in your hands?
This is the injunction. It's got 11 different statements in here for me to consider and follow. So, like it says, shall not stop or park a vehicle along a public road within 100 feet of the entrance to a Cabot access road, which means driveway. That's number 5. And shall not enter on foot within 25 feet of the entrance of access road, except may be present on foot on the opposite side of the public road. And this is my command to when I bring other people. I'm restrained and enjoined and prohibited from authorizing, directing, ratifying, inciting, or giving specific instructions to others to engage in specific criminal or torturous activity against Cabot or GDS, which is a subcontractor, another company that Cabot owns. Defendant Scroggins will advise any people she brings to or near Cabot leased property that it is illegal to block the access road. So when I had people on Monday with a tour, I told them don't block the driveway, the entrance. I usually tell them too, don't block any traffic and don't trespass, which means usually, according to Cabot, don't even cross the road. Don't even walk up to the guard shack, which might be 100 feet from the road. Don't inquire and just walk up to the gate. They consider everything trespassing right off the road. So I'm not to interfere with their marked pipeline right-of-ways on Cabot lease property. And if I'm near a Cabot gas site, like there's a gas site across the road, and I'm on private property where I have permission, I have to stay 100 feet away from an active site. An inactive site, 25 feet. Otherwise, I'm in violation. I can be dragged to court under contempt. I can be then found guilty of contempt, civil contempt, subject to fines, assessment of attorney fees, or incarceration in a proper case, whatever that might be. And at the last, this last thing here, it said that I waive the right to challenge and will not challenge or appeal the terms of this order. So I find that objectionable. That's why I didn't sign this third injunction. I refused to sign it when it was given to me. And supposedly I had agreed to these things, but I never agreed to, I can't challenge or appeal these terms. I find that unacceptable. So that's my order, which was from May 1st of this year, that my judge in my county, Judge Siemens, agreed to and thought this was acceptable. to force on me, even though I refused to sign it. I was supposed to sign it, and Cabot was supposed to sign it. So that's what I'm living with right now, and it's permanent for the rest of my life. And hopefully, I'm hoping that if Cabot falls apart as a company, goes bankrupt like a bunch of other companies have, that maybe my injunction will die with the death of the company. So that's my one thing I can look forward to. Yeah, so I have here Cabot is trying their best to make an image of someone who is always trespassing, does all kinds of illegal things. Meanwhile, I have no charges ever with the law about trespassing. I have no police reports, no charges in 5 years that I was doing it before they finally dragged me to court. So then Cabot decides to build a case. So after they took me to court, over the past 2 years, they've been compiling. They already have 52 letters, form letters. So they make a form letter, and they give it to landowners who they're going to develop or put a site on. And most of them, 95%, I don't even know who they are. I've never heard their names. I don't know where they are. I've never been to their property. So what Cabot does, it's a form letter, and they'll say, no address. And we ask them about that. Why can't you even have the decency to give me an address? I have to look it up in the courthouse. They want me to look up things. Or they're hoping I just stumble on this property and I'll be in trouble. So this is the Colwell property and parcel number. So I have to go to the courthouse, look it up. Right now I wrote all the names on here, so at least I have names. So in case I might see a name somewhere, I avoid that property. Anything I think might be Cabot lease, I avoid if I don't know it. So I have all the names I wrote out, and we're aware of the fact. They're aware of the fact. What fact? This Cabot just writes anything they want. That Vera has repeatedly trespassed onto numerous properties in Susquehanna County where Cabot is conducting gas operations. We do not want Miss Scroggins on any portion of our property. They don't know me personally at all. I've never been to their place. We do not give Miss Scroggins or any individual associated with Miss Scroggins permission to come on any portion for any reason. I guess even if I'm bleeding, I have a gunshot wound, and I need help, I can't go to that property and ask for help and ask them to call 911 because it says here, for any purpose. So I just have to go and lay in the street and hopefully somebody finds me. We consider any entry on our property by Miss Scroggins to constitute criminal trespass. 52 of these throughout my county. This is Cabot building a case against me. So now Cabot has had people call them and say, oh yeah, we saw her. She's wandering around on our site, on a gas site that's being prepared. And they told my lawyers about it. And when they told me the location, kind of the location of town, because they didn't give the full address yet, the name of the owner, I said, I don't know anything about that. I never heard that name. Where is it? I usually don't go there. Then when I looked it up, I've never been there. Then finally, they said they had a photograph, and they gave a photograph with no image of me in it, some kind of fuzzy image in the way distance, and they put an X on it. And then when you brought it close in and tried to blow it up, you can't see anything. So for them, it's like Vera sightings. They would like to have Vera sightings, and that's what happens. People will call in. They claim they see me. So I'm like Bigfoot now in the county. So just look for me. You see a woman with gray hair. People tell me to wear different wigs. Or others will wear my wigs. Some friends have said they want to dress like me, wear wigs, and then wander around. So they'll have Vera sightings several places at the same time in the county. And then what do they do? What will they do with that? So this is what I'm dealing with. It's like a comedy, except that it's annoying and disturbing. And I'm waiting for my next day in court for the next Vera sighting.